I remember Anne walking out and praying on the, I don't know the watchmen what were they were thinking. She just got out of her vehicle and was praying outside. I had the baby. I think I gave baby to Melody. I mean, we were like two mad women, you know, not sad or anything. We were praying. Welcome to our week's episode. This is Caroline and this is
Kayleen.
Kayleen is my firstborn daughter, and we've been doing a series of stuff on family and a lot of other things. And today we're gonna talk about prayer, faith, trust. So we may not talk about anything specific about family and growth, but we're going to talk about the family of God and God's grace. You're going to use some amazing testimonies that how God has taken us through, and I hope God will speak to us just like he has spoken to us. Now before I tell you that, I give Kayleen a chance to give a testimony, I'm going to share with you what prompted this. Let me tell you something really amazing, really sweet. I am doing my first fiction Christian novel. Yay!
Mm. Oh, you're telling them?
Yes.
Oh. Yeah, she said. It's really nice.
It's you're the first person to hear about it. So I'm doing my first Christian fiction novel. It's basically done. It's based on the story of Joseph. And because of this, I've had to do a lot of research. I've had to do a lot of, reading the word and backgrounds and everything. And it's an amazing revelation even to myself. And while I was at it, I came across Genesis 43 verse 35. I'm at this place where Genesis 43 verse 35 to 36. Allow me to read it for you. So, okay, Lynn, you can read this for us.
As they emptied out their sacks, there in each man's sack was the bag of money he had paid for the grain. The brothers and their father were terrified when they saw the bags of money. Jacob exclaimed, "You are robbing me of my children. Joseph is gone, Simeon is gone, and now you want to take Benjamin too? Everything is going against me."
So basically, I want you to take the key word here. Everything is going against me. That's what Jacob felt. That everything was going against him. Now, before we get into it, I want to give you a background of this whole story, just a perspective, okay? Now, there's a drought in Egypt, but of course, it affects Israel, probably Syria, everywhere, the Middle East. And at that particular time, we all know the story. Egypt is sorted because God spoke through Joseph, but the rest of the world is not sorted. So Jacob and his children are starving. Now, we all know Jacob was the Chris Kirubi of Kenya, the Dangote. You know, he was the Bill Gates of then. He was the richest man. Now, of course, the rich will die latest in hunger. Mm. So Joseph, at that particular, Jacob and his children, they have run out of food. Mpaka even their money cannot do anything. Mm. So he tells his sons, "Stop staring at each other here. You know, just go. I hear there's food in Egypt. This is money. The problem was in money. This is money. Go buy food." And they go buy food and they meet Joseph. Of course, they don't know this is the brother they killed or wanted to kill. Now, these guys, I have to give you a perspective to the story of Joseph. Now, some scholars say the brothers actually threw him in the hole to die. But then one brother, I think it was Judah, I don't know, is the one who saved him from the hole. So the rest of the brothers do not know he was sold as a slave. Mm-hmm. Because it always confuses me when I hear them saying our brother died. They were so confident their brother died.
Yeah.
Honestly, if they had sold him as a slave, they would have had a hint, kidogo, you know, he might not actually have died. Yeah. So definitely the brothers think the brother died. If you go back 20 years before now and they throw him in the hole, they realize that, you realize that Jacob was heartbroken. Now, for me, Jacob is a dreamer. His father, Abraham, who was Jacob's dad?
Who was Jacob's dad?
Jacob and Esau.
Isaac.
Isaac. Isaac is a dreamer. Abraham is a dreamer. You understand? Mm. So I believe there's no chance that Jacob over the years, over 20 years, he'd not even dreamt or heard from God.
Mm.
He must have sensed somehow Joseph really, really never died.
Mm.
You understand? But the reality of the matter is that he was brought his blooded coat and he was told the son has died.
Mm.
Now, I'm looking at this situation and thinking, Jacob, this is his moment of glory.
Mm.
He is about to meet this dead son, who he thought was dead, to be alive. And I thought we get into that situation many, 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 many times. We get into that situation where we are telling ourselves, oh my God, my world is over. It is over. Where is this God? You know, and yet that is actually our moment of salvation.
Mm.
The pain that Jacob was feeling at that time of being told to send Benjamin, of being able to be returned the money, and all the things that were happening was actually not a curse. It wasn't a bad thing. Good things were about to happen, but Jacob was not able to read because he was reading physical circumstance, not what God is doing. And today that is what I want to encourage. And to do this, I want to ask Kaylin to share a testimony. 2 years ago, she left for America for a program called Transition One, which was purely a miracle because just before
what
she...
What are the chances? I'm actually wearing the t-shirt right now.
Oh, you're wearing a Transition One t-shirt?
Yeah, but you can't see it because it's the other way around.
Yeah. So she was living for a program called Transition One. It's a gap year. She just finished her grade 11 and God had spoken to us. Now, before, like 5 months before, we were okay financially, 4 months. And then like immediately she was accepted, everything started going downhill. And everything that would work against her going was going to happen. It's a Christian program. I felt in my heart that is what she needed more than going quickly to university or anything. I felt it's the life, we, George and I, felt it was the life skill she needed. And everything worked, she was accepted. She was only 16 then. They actually told me they never accepted anyone who was 16.
Mm.
She was the first one. Luckily, just before joining the program, she was turning 17.
Mm.
But even then, they had canceled. So everything had really worked to her going. But eventually, we go through all these hurdles, and it is the morning of her leaving. And what happened?
Before we left, we decided to, of course, we slept. That was the day of my going.
Mm.
But that night, I dreamt that I missed my flight. I dreamt that I had missed my flight, and then I was able to get back onto another flight. So that was very, it was very like scary because weeks before there were still many other factors that we went through for me not to, you know, there was a lot of stuff going on financially, the fact that we even got that money to get into the plane, the fact that we even got back to Kenya at that time because still financially we're not okay.
So Melody wasn't even in school
at that
she had missed I think a week of school.
And there was just so much drama with that, and then with my visa there were things that we were not sure if they're gonna, you know, those
work out.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. But it did, and it like everything, like because there were like 10 things that were not supposed to work out. Like 10 things
impossible.
Impossible things to happen.
Mm.
So that day, at I say to someone, I'm going to America this week.
Mm.
Do you know I didn't tell, we didn't actually tell everyone. I don't even think our family knew.
No, until the last.
Until the that Friday, which was also something we were not supposed to
do.
But, like it looked, even God warned us because it looked like there was so much
resistance
that God was like, just don't
say anything
when
to
she's
anyone
there,
until, yeah,
you
until
will talk about
needs,
it.
Yes,
because guys, it was just insane. There was so much resistance. I was just like, you know those things that you, it's as if you can't, like there's a door and another door and another door that you have to open and open and open and open. So when I said the dream, it's not the best thing to hear
on the morning or
after that whole episode of just drama in the back. So we when we did that, we prayed that morning.
We were at my friend Anne and Baptist.
Oh, yeah.
So Anne, the church has morning glory. Mm. So the night before, she said, okay, guys, Easy Vita, they are on another level. So tomorrow we're going to wake up while we left home at 4, all packed, and went for morning glory in Thika Road from Kiliman, you know, before the traffic jam was done. So we went to pray.
By the way, did we book the airplane in Kenya or in Rwanda?
In Rwanda. No, we booked, the ticket was booked in Kenya, but Daddy booked here from Rwanda.
Okay. But we did get the money ticket. In Kenya.
Yes. The money was sent when you were in Kenya. That was another testimony by itself, but that one would take a whole episode. So basically, we've gone for prayer. So Kaylin has woken up and said, guys, I had this dream. And we're like, oh my God, the enemy wants now, after all this, you're going to miss the flight. Mm. So we decided, you know what, after we go for morning prayers, we will not go back to Anne's house because the flight was in the evening.
Yeah.
We will go to Kayo Seja Embakasi.
Like, I remember even her driving so fast and we were like 3 hours. Was it four? Not three. Yeah. It was like four hours.
Yeah, and also the other miracle that happened was Anne was going to work. So after the morning glory, which ends at 8:30, I think, she was to get back to work and we were to get into an Uber. Mm. And then when we were praying, God spoke to her to actually take us. So she asked for permission, which was really hard. And then now she took us to the airport.
Mm.
Now that was key. And taking us to the airport was actually key to this whole mystery.
I would have never, thank you. I would have literally never gone. This testimony of going to the US,
She was the divine connection. She was the helper, other part, divine helper.
Literally.
Sent to by God at that particular time.
If she never had God, I don't even know what would have happened. Mm. Trust me, this would have been another sad story. And we would have sat down here saying, oh God.
Maybe God.
It's the will of God. Yeah. But it wasn't. God's will was for me to go, and so like,
which is why it's very important to hear God.
That was just amazing. So anyway, so we go, and I remember her driving so quick and frustrated, and we were 5 hours or 4 hours.
Not four, it was like,
it was nine.
We are driving at 9:10.
My flight was like
at six, I think
6:37. Yeah. There. So she was
like, we don't traffic jam. We don't nothing.
And you know, to be honest, we really, as you said before, we take visions and dreams very seriously.
Yeah.
Which is something that, thank God, we learned years before. Because imagine if I didn't take we didn't take that dream seriously. I don't even know.
Mm.
So anyway, we go and my dad was in another Airbnb.
He had just come from
on the other
Kigali
side.
That night.
Yeah. So he was on the other side. I think
Embakasi.
He was in Embakasi at that time. And so that's what happened. So we go pick up my dad. Oh, and as we were going, we went with all the clothes. We went with
everything.
We were not coming back. I was not planning to come back because we weren't ready for that drama.
Mm.
So we tried everything. I think, we tried everything. We went, we picked Daddy up. We even told Daddy the dream. I remember us in the car telling him, you know what, we dreamt Kelly, right?
Yeah.
She dreamt this and even
said,
him.
Let's go to the airport.
Yeah, even him, he was
let's
like,
let's go to a hotel outside the airport.
He said, let's go
to 4 points. Like, if anything happens, we can walk to the airport.
The conviction of that day, the conviction of that dream, you know, like, also, one of the reasons that we survived this whole time, the opposition before it, the fact that I got the visa, we had a dream about it that night before.
Actually, every single step
I had a dream.
Warning,
there was somebody who had a dream, you know.
Mm-hmm.
And trust me, like every dream, like I remember, like before we even went to Kenya, there's a dream we had, and that exactly happened. But because of God, it changed. So it was like God shows me a dream, and it's like, you know, like for example, Kaylin, you're gonna fight with someone about this, or Kaylin, you're not gonna get your visa.
Mm.
Okay, I was gonna say God forbid, but I got my visa, so like Kaylin, you're not gonna get your visa to go to the US at that specific time. Then we would pray about it, and it would change.
The narrative would change.
It would happen like Kaylin is not about to get her visa, but she does get her visa.
Exactly.
So that's exactly how those steps are going. Like, every single step, even I don't even remember what we, I was it. Yeah, I don't know what you dreamt about the visa, but we were so sure we're gonna get it. I remember mommy was about to jump when I got the visa. So guys, it was like,
yeah, because just the visa. Do you remember when you were going for the visa interview, God telling me go to this guy.
And in
the US embassy you can't decide who you go to, like five guys. So God says, don't go to this woman.
There's a line. You follow a line.
Yes.
No.
And so if we landed to that woman, there's nothing. We'd have gone to that woman.
Which?
So because it looked like I was going to talk to reach to that woman, I started praying in tongues and praying that the person there delays.
Yeah. And there's a lot of drama, by the way. Like, that woman started having drama with this old woman.
Yes.
And this old woman was saying she wants to go to a conference.
It was a church conference.
Church conference and to do the sign.
She was giving some stupid answers there.
And she was...
So finally, we were not able to go to
the one.
We went to another young
man. Yeah, we went to this young man.
Yeah.
And he was like, he was like, to check if it's a credible thing and all these things, and we ended up actually going.
Getting a visa on the first interview.
And that was just amazing. And I had friends at that time who had just been denied all
even
throughout.
Two times, three times.
Yeah. So it wasn't the best, you know, it wasn't as if like, oh. So when I hear people say, oh, that's nice that you went. I don't think you understand. There's a lot of drama. There's a lot of prayer that went into it, and a lot of drama. And I don't know why the devil. I didn't want you to know. I don't think we understood the intensity of why God wanted me to go there at that time.
Because
there was so much opposition. My goodness. So anyway, as we're going into the airport. We get into the airport, I remember very nicely, and we go to our hotel. And
4 points in the airport, inside the airport.
We couldn't, you know, there could be a bomb blast. Not letting us enter the airport.
Yeah.
You never know. Yeah. You don't know the
airport.
Just
stayed right there from 2.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Kenya can be like, you know, no entering the airports anymore. You never know. Because at that point, anything could happen. Aliens could come down. Anything.
Yeah.
You know. So we were just like, we will be in the airport at that specific time. So we went inside 4 points and bought for us food. And she was really nice. Like, she really
angel,
helped
she
out.
She was an angel, really.
Yeah. And so we ended up, so we ate. And after we were done eating, I think it was around 1. And even that one, we were sure we have to be inside.
Like an hour before the check-in time.
Inside, you know, like that place that people stand. So we go with my dad and we hug each other. Mom didn't have that mindset. Like, there was so much
panic that I didn't have a chance. Remember, she just turned 17. Like, she was still 16 in my mind, or 15, she's still my child. We were panicking and trusting God and pushing, and I did not have a chance to think I'll miss her. Oh my God, she's gone. Okay, I wasn't really that worried because you're going with Daddy. If you were traveling alone, I would have been
worried. But Daddy wasn't going to stay with you.
I mean, just for a week, yes. Yeah. But still, I did not. Actually, the impact I felt is that after we said bye, we hugged each other, and then when we were driving away, then I got that huge feeling of, oh my God. What happened? She is leaving for, you know, 22 hours away from us by flight, you know, like the other side of the world. And she's gone, you know, that's when it hit me.
Yeah, I was like, I'm actually going. For me, it wasn't even, I feel like, yes, there was so much opposition and everything, but also I could not believe. You know, it sounds very ironic. Because the whole point was faith,
and then we reached there.
But to me, I still couldn't click that I'm actually entering a plane. Because I remember very nice. Oh, we'll talk about it later. But I was actually entering the plane. So we get in, they ask for our passports.
Not into the plane, into check-in.
Into
no,
check-in now.
Check-in,
they ask for our passports to enter. Do you know, like in
actually reach where you you've come out, and I'm like, I didn't believe I can even
see. Oh, yeah. So, yeah. So when she saw my face, she was like, I can't believe I'm seeing you again. Like,
and the reason was because I had been so down that she was leaving. And then I was like, no, I don't want to see her. Like that sadness. I don't care how I feel. I just want them gone, you know.
Mm. So like, she was just like, nope, I will feel it bad when she goes to the US. But so this whole drama happened. And then I saw my plane leaving. And I was like, wow, I should have been there. Now, the first thing that hit us all was the dream, because yes. I remember sitting down even before we called you guys. Me and Daddy were sitting down, and Daddy could not believe it, like the dream actually came true. He was like, any killing your dream has actually come true, you need to start praying. That's exactly what he said,
and that's exactly what he told me as well.
Yeah,
when he called us, we're on Mombasa Road, we're going back to Anne's place, and he said, I think you guys need to pray. It looks like our tickets are not going through. By then they had not said. When I looked at it, I think it was 15 minutes or 30 minutes to the flight time. I mean, you know that time when it's too late for you to. Now, let me tell you what was going on in my mind at that particular time. I am action oriented, you know. I'm the type that wants to make things. It's a bit of a control freak stream there. But I'm like, no. You remember we've tried to control the effect of this dream the whole day physically. And still it
also
had
we
happened.
Prayed.
We prayed totally in the morning, and we continued even trusting God. So at that particular time, I realized there's nothing physical we can do apart from praying. Because he said he tried to get us to get the ticketing office to do a return ticket, which was impossible. It was 6. They had closed. There was nothing they could do that quickly until the plane went. But I remember praying. And praying, because I remember, if you remember, your dream exactly was that you were about to miss the flight, then you got it.
Yeah.
Now, I was like, this is, in my mind, this is the flight she's going to get, you know. So it's like 40 minutes, 30
also,
minutes.
Also, you have
this
to talk about,
she has to get it.
When Daddy called her, she was very down. Now, this is another thing where I was actually very important. She basically said, it's either you accept it or you pray about
so she brought me to perspective. I think we hadn't even finished conversing that conversation when Daddy called, and suddenly my perspective changed. Like, yeah, let her go, you know, like I cannot even allow my feelings right now to come in. And so, by the way, we stopped in a parking and prayed first. We prayed and couldn't believe it. We got into some bank in the Mombasa Road, because we knew there's no way with the jam we'll get back on time. I remember Anne walking out and praying on the, I don't know the watchmen what were they were thinking. She just got out of her vehicle and was praying outside. I had baby. I think I gave baby to Melody. I mean, we were like two mad women, you know. Not sad or anything, we were praying and declaring.
Because when you know when you know God has told you something,
yes, you claim it.
You claim it.
So you are claiming
there's
that
no
flight.
Demon that can frustrate it. I mean, not frustrate it, that can do anything.
Change
to
anything.
Stop it. So
yes.
The only God, you know God is gonna do what he's gonna do. But also if he tells you, pray about it.
Yeah.
Then pray.
And if he shows you an outcome. For me,
imagine if they were like, oh, how sad.
Remember, for me the outcome was you will travel. For Anne, the outcome was you will travel. Now the difference between me and Anne was that me, I was like, this is the plane she will travel with.
Yeah.
And Anne was open to God. That was the difference. So anyway, eventually,
so what's so funny is that the point was that Kayleen is going to travel on that day. Because I remember, guys, I had dreamt, first of all, actually one of the sad things is that the week before I had dreamt I was supposed to go that Friday, but we sinned by telling someone.
Yeah.
So I didn't end up going on that Friday. But we knew that Monday. Was it a Monday?
It was Monday, yes.
Yes. We knew that Monday. No, the next.
It was Tuesday morning.
It was sure that God has said this day is when you're going. So as we took it, we were like, for sure that day is when Kayleen is going, not the next, not any other time. That's the day she's going. So God is fine.
Remember when God is saying you will go on Friday, it's not because of anything, because we don't have the ticket. We didn't have money for your ticket.
Yeah.
So we are like, oh, how will she go? But God said she will go. Okay. Yes. So anyway, so we miss the Friday because and this is another thing, I hope we'll talk about it. When God gives you conditions, like in the Old Testament, it's so critical. Moses would tell them, if you obey, there will be good consequences. Mm. If you disobey. So if God gives you instructions and you don't follow them, then there are consequences. Mm. So like you're missing the flight that Friday was our consequence because we did not obey, we did not do what God had said.
Yeah.
So anyway, the next, now your flight goes. So we turn around with Anne. To me, we turned around to come and pick you because now the devil has won. You know, like you were supposed to get the flight, you did not get it. Let's come.